Darren Klemm, the Foreign Emergency Services Commissioner, and I'm here with you this afternoon to talk about what's been occurring today with both the weather and also a series of bushfire and structure fire incidents we've had across the state. These conditions, while a really strong cold front is normal for this time of year, we've had extremely dry conditions from January through to May, and in fact, driest conditions on record, and they have proven to cause some challenges for us in controlling a whole series of bushfires that have occurred today. Once we had the initial briefing on Monday from the Bureau of Met, there were five water bombers brought online, as well as two helitacks. Total fire bans were declared late yesterday for large parts of the southwest today, and a whole series of operational crews, both careers and volunteer firefighters, have been put on standby, and of course State Emergency Service volunteers as well for the impending storm event that's going to occur tonight and into the weekend. Some fires of particular note, including the one at Baldivis in the southeast of the metropolitan area, has resulted in the closure of the freeway. The Kwinana Freeway, both north and south, is closed down at Mundajong Road. In the southwest of the state, we see a series of fires have occurred, particularly one at Jarrawood, which has run through the settlement of Jarrawood, but due to the great work of the crews down there, the 18 structures or houses that exist there in Jarrawood have been saved, and the fires have gone around the town and continued on into the forest there. And then just when you might assume that it's all about bushfire, later this afternoon we had a structure fire near the corner of Kewdale Road and the Tonkin Highway. That fire is still occurring as we speak, and we have a Department of Water and Environment and Regulation there doing a testing of the atmosphere there to make sure that people downwind of that fire can stay in place. And we do encourage people to keep their windows closed and the doors shut to make sure that they're not getting smoke inside their house. So, of course, what we're going to see occur over the next 36 to 48 hours is the passage of a cold front through the metropolitan area, hopefully out into the wheat belt to bring some rain to the farmers out there, but also into the southwest to the Capes region. And so we do encourage homeowners to make sure that they're cleaning up, and they've done that cleaning up around their home, clean out those gutters, make sure everything that's loose and could be blown around is put away or tied down to make sure that they don't present a danger either to themselves or to other members of the community. It has been an incredibly hectic day for all the crews, for all the volunteer and career firefighters and the State Emergency Service, and I'd like to thank all of them for the great work that they've done. We've had fantastic assistance with the Parks and Wildlife crews, local government, with the Bureau of Met. It truly has been a team effort to combat a difficult and challenging day in emergency services.